Hello friends, welcome to 7th episode of Happy School web series. This episode is specially made for teachers, aspiring educators, principals and school administrators who have got passion in teaching profession. And my special thanks to Saraswati World School, International Organization of Education Charter CCLP Worldwide and Universal Education Charter Campaign for making this video possible. Let's begin this topic. Can I ask you one thing? What is one thing that has changed our life over a period of time, that has completely reshaped the way we are living our life? And that one thing, I guess you all know, is technology. Technology has completely changed our life. There, it has extended the level of convenience and comfort for human life. Never before in thousands of years, human life has received such level of comfort and convenience only because of the use of technology. If you can see, technology is everywhere. If you are in the home or office or factory, you are indoor or outdoor, you always with technology. Technology is always there in every aspect of human life. Then how can technology be not there in education industry, especially in teaching industry? So teaching is a serious profession. It's serious because ultimately the future of any country depends on teachers, schools. So technology has to be there in teaching profession. Now, there are some questions in education industries without which there is no mention of technology. What are those questions for which technology is in reply? The first thing, that is the rich and quality education learning experience, rich and quality learning experience for every students. This is the first question. How can we achieve this? And the reply is use of technology in teaching. The second one is, can we develop a curriculum which fits every kind of students? Whether a student is of high IQ or low IQ, whether students from far European countries or from Asian countries, everybody included in that curriculum, that format of education available to everyone. The third one is, what would be the role of technology in personalized learning? And the fourth one is digital literacy skill. I mean, the digital, how to understand or communicate in digital landscape. If you see in today's world, there are various technology in use in teaching profession. Some are more advanced, some are very old but yet in use. Some very popular but very advanced technologies are 3D printing, biometrics, hologram, cloud technology, virtual reality. These kind of technologies are started to be in use in teaching profession and other training modules. But these technologies are in very nascent stage, and impact of such technology on education is yet to be known. But I will limit myself to some of the basic technology and the area where technology can be used. Very basic, which every teacher has to know. Let's start with that. The first one, the first dimension is STEM education and NEST methodology. The second one is personalized learning. The third one is use of mobile app and online ERP solutions. And the fourth one that I already told you, digital literacy skill development. Now I will explain each of the dimension of use of technology individually. The first is STEM education. STEM stands for science, technology, engineering and math. Science we all living in the science world. Everywhere, whether it's home or office, everywhere you will see the impact of science. What is technology? Technology is the application of science for the convenience and comfort of human life. And the third one is the engineering. Engineering is whatever we see standing, whether it's in the home or in office or factory, everything that is present, that is functioning, it's all the gift of engineering excellence. And the fourth one is mathematics. Of course, maths, if you're doing business, any entrepreneurship, then math is a part of that work. So these four skills can be taught by use of technology. And what kind of technology we can use? From a simple blackboard, it's a very basic technology, to an advanced robotics lab. From a simple book library, to an interactive language laboratory. From a simple presentation, to a multimedia interactive presentations. Whatever tool we use based on the technology, it will deal with STEM education. And for in order to understand STEM education, technology is a primary tool. The second one is NEST methodology. NEST stands for Nature, Environment, Science and Technology. Basically, it's an overview of how to balance between nature and science. On the one hand, the student will understand the basics of nature and environment. On the other hand, the prudent use of technology and science in human life. So this is the basic idea of NEST methodology. And technology is again required to give this kind of education to students. This is the first thing. The second one is we can use the app, mobile applications and ERP solutions that is available to schools. There are a lot of mobile apps are in running in various schools, and one of the biggest company in the world, Google, it has already launched Google Classroom. Microsoft is also taken initiative in this direction with Microsoft Education's community portals, from where teachers, students, administrators can get the resources, can share the resources, can get the trainings and everything. It's a wonderful platform. So mobile app and ERP solutions is a very much part of our education system, and it's a technology that is delivering this to the hand of students. The third one is the personalized learning that I told you earlier. Personalized learning is a question of availability, accessibility and understandability. How can we reach out to every student? How can we make every student learn, understand the topic with the use of technology? This is the third one. And the last one is the digital literacy skill. Why digital literacy skill? Because in today's world, we communicate through different mode of digital avenues. And if we need to communicate, navigate with students, then we need to understand the digital complexities or digital availability. So for that purpose, technology is an important tool. And with the help of technological tools, we can actually communicate, navigate the digital landscape for students, for teachers. So these are the basic availability of technology and its scope in teaching profession. Whether a teacher is a novice in ICT skills, but yet he has to know, or she has to know all about this basic technological usage and the scope. I hope that you will like this video. If you have got any comments or any queries, you can always email us at our email address. And if you like this video, please like us, share us and comment below this video. We'll come back again with interesting topic next Wednesday. And I hope that you will like this video. Thank you so much.